What's your funnest thing about doing a cooking show?
Well, I mean, I love to cook, but the thing for me is that I didn't want to be just like standing behind a counter going, now you add the butter. So I said, can I have my sister on and my best friends and my so every week
y'all just
like,
make a mess
and we just have fun. So it's all people that I love, people that I know, and we're pretty fast and furious. We just shot 15 episodes in 16 days.
Golly.
So we're pretty. It's pretty hardcore. You
that's
know, when
rocking,
you're shooting, but it's good.
Yeah. So what kind of, I mean, at some point you've run out of your recipes and your favorite things to cook. So then where'd you go?
Well, this I'm working on a third book that's coming out next year. And it's...
Your book, by the way, to interrupt you, is beautiful.
Thank you.
I mean, it's awesome. I was just real impressed the way it's done. And it looks great. And it's easy to read and understand what you're talking about. So as far as cookbooks go, really great job.
Thank you. Because having read a bunch of books and I know what I love about a book and what I don't. And I wanted to be a ton of pictures. Because if you want to make something, I want you to be able to see what it's supposed to look
yeah.
like.
Yeah.
So I was real adamant about exactly how I want it to look. I don't like it when all the pictures are in the middle. So when you have to flip back to find the picture
right,
what you're making.
Right,
so
right.
We really did work hard on trying to make it user friendly. But in the last, I guess, year and a half, I lost some weight and I was like, okay, I love this comfort food, but I don't eat this way every day. So So the next book is sort of how I figured out how to still have things that I love to eat. And we've got all the comfort food stuff in there, but we also have how to substitute things to make them a little bit healthier or to make things that maybe you don't want to have meat every single night or whatever. And so they're just what happens when you start to do this is people give you recipes all the time. So it seems like I always have something new coming in the house, even though I've made grandma's fried chicken already and I've already done, you know, all that. So there still seems to be a plethora of recipes out there.
You're a liar. How can you eat like that and lose weight? I mean,
you don't eat that way all the time. I mean, I say in the new book, it's the 80-20 rule, which is like 80% of the time you make good choices. And 20% of the time, if you're going to go off the chart,
yeah,
have something good and have something that is homemade. If you're going to have dessert, make it that key lime cake that you really love. I mean, if you're going to do it right. But don't do that every day. And that works. It works for me.
So when you go off the chart, do you still compromise, or when you go off the chart, do
no.
you just like hand
no.
me the Crisco? We're going
absolutely.
In.
We're not gonna. Yeah, if we're going, we're going whole hog, so to speak. It's gonna be fried chicken and mashed potatoes and gravy, and I mean, we're not gonna skimp on anything. If we're going, we're going hard.
Well, tell me about Chicago. So you guys did what, 11 shows in how many days?
We did 2 shows a night in some nights. So it was like
6 days or something?
6 or 7 days. Yeah.
You did some matinees or something too, right?
Yeah, there was some two. There was like a 6:30 show and a 10:30 show a couple of nights,
okay.
And it actually was, you know, the crowds were so incredible that the first night I felt kind of a lull after the first show, and I thought, oh, I got 2 hours for this next or an hour for this next show, but once you step out there, that adrenaline, you know, I mean, that
sure.
adrenaline kicks in, and you get a second wind, and it was awesome.
Somebody told me when those dates started going up first, I said, you know, of course I ran into Garth at Bohemian Grove, and I said, so you got to be excited. He goes, well, I'm a little nervous. I said, shut up.
But
you're
he
not
is.
Nervous.
He totally is. I think maybe he thinks if he says he thinks they're going to sell that it'll jinx the whole thing and nobody will show up, but he's always nervous. He's always seemed surprised that people buy tickets. So I'm like, honey, I feel good about this. I think it's going to be all right.
No kidding. And anyway, and they were saying, well, how's he going to, how can he do, you know, 10 shows? And what I said, you know, when he came, you guys, excuse me, both of you, and had some other friends visit, came to Nashville, Reba and I went and out to her suite and watched you one night when he was raising money for the flood stuff,
yeah.
When you both were. And I don't know how, I think you guys had done 6 shows or something at that time, and it was great. I mean, both of you just... The energy was there. I'm like, you know, this is going to be so good. And I told him, we were laughing about it that night. He goes, well, I don't know about the new music and whatever. I said, well, that may be something else to, you know, that you have to deal with being out for several semesters here.
Right.
But as far as your fans, you know, they're coming and you're gonna get to perform and do as many shows as you want to.
Yeah.
And
what's been cool is that my show now is in the middle of his show. So I come out and I do my set kind of in the middle of his show, which is cool. We kind of took Vegas where I would come out and do a couple of songs and we expanded it to where instead of opening, my show's kind of in the middle of his show. And I'm amazed that, I mean, they sing, you know, but it's so cool to see everybody singing these songs. And there, some of these people were not alive when She's in Love with a Boy came out. I don't know how they're knowing these. I guess their parents knew them and they know them. But it's really been cool to see the age difference of all the people that are at the shows and that they know the music, because a lot of these kids weren't born when he and I, you know, made a record last.
We kind of got going around the same time,
yeah,
didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
And I see, you know, I still go out tour solo now, and those songs like Brand New Man and, you know, You're Gonna Miss Me, songs that are 20-something years old. And yeah. I guess they find these old dusty CDs. And you're right. Their parents are. You think there's something about the mentality of still they hear about it, and legend is the wrong word, but, you know, there's this, oh, obviously I've heard of you guys. So, and then maybe go buy the music. Do you see, you know, people for the first time maybe, and it's going to a concert. You know how I used to do for sure when I was going to go to a show, you just play the heck out of that music before you go.
Absolutely. So, yeah, that's true. And then, and that's exactly right. You know, I was a big Linda Ronstadt fan, and I remember just playing her music all the way in the cassette player, all the way to the gig, you know, all the way to the theater to hear her sing. So I guess that is what it is. It just, and also country music, you know, is unique in that fans really are lifelong fans, and they really do teach their kids the music that they love. You know, I mean, I listen to George Jones and Tammy Wynette because that's what my parents listened to, and my daddy loved him some George Jones, and so, you know, those songs were all recorded before I was born, the ones he was listening to, and I loved him just like that. So I guess it makes sense.
What is a highlight, Ben? I mean, what has really struck you as, oh, I wasn't expecting this, or since you've come back?
Well, I think for me, you know, my perspective is I've always felt like I would hopefully be an artist that would make records for as long as I have a voice. But I've never looked at my career like every song's got to be a number one record, or I may not sell a gazillion records, but I want to just be able to do it. And I want to have success, but I always just think about, I just want to be able to make the music because I love to do it so much. And so I think the biggest surprise to me has been, even though we're just getting started, this song that I've found called Prize Fighter, that's the first single, is there's an excitement around it that I wasn't really thinking about. I was just thinking, I love this song and there's something special about it. But the response has been so cool so far. So that's been unexpected. And even though just starting this tour, I'm doing the song in the show and people are starting to sing it, you know, so it's cool. It's a nice surprise.
Great. Well, you know, at Cumulus now, we have now an icon format that we're building. We're flipping stations right and left. And I was talking to John Dickey last week, and he was saying in several demographics, it's already won the market here in Nashville. I mean, people are clamoring to this, and it's neck and neck across almost all demographics. So obviously, from when we kind of came on board, like from Clinton Garth starting in 89 or so up until, you know, the current where you're having acts like Alan and, you know, even George not getting played so much now on mainstream radio, these acts are still making great music, have huge fan bases, are still out and playing, and, you know, and it's obvious there's a fan base there that's going, where'd our artists go? Or where'd those artists go?
Well, I mean, it's in every genre of music, if you think about it. I mean, you know, the Eagles don't have to ever make another record if they don't want to, but people are going to go see them perform. That music is timeless, and people want to hear it. I do. I mean, I'm a fan, you know. So I think it's, you know, Springsteen. He's, you know, it's like these are the tours that people go, I want to see that show.
If it's good, it's good.
If it's good, it's good.
Yeah. So this song, and it's funny, I was doing my overnight show with my partner, Suzanne Alexander, who you probably know.
I do.
And she goes, I love it. In fact, she hadn't heard it yet. And I said, play a piece of that thing, Lonnie. And he plays it. And she starts running and plays. She goes, God, it just fires me up. It just makes me want to go. Of course, the song is Prize Fighter. And I said, yeah, it's, you know, it's sort of, I guess, Eye of the Tiger theme, but it's kind of pumps you up and makes you want to go. I can only imagine how many songs you probably listen to. There's so many great songs being written in Nashville right now.
True.
What was it about that one that hit you between the eyes or between the ears and made you go, I got to sing this?
It was that. I mean, you know, I feel like I'm hard on songs. I feel like they have to they have to really move me in some way. And I'm not really, I would say I'm not really like an anthem singer. I mean, How Do I Live was probably the closest thing to a song that was really kind of
killed it,
kind of a song that, you know, just that touched people in that way. But when I heard Prize Fighter, it's funny that you mentioned Eye of the Tiger, because I thought about Rocky Balboa, and I thought about, it's kind of taking the gamut. I, not to get too serious, but I lost my mom to cancer about 3 years ago, and she was the classiest sick person I've ever met. She had such grace, and she was so, her attitude about the whole thing. And I thought about her a lot when I heard that song, and I thought, man, she would love this song. So I've got, and it's been interesting that those are the, that's the gamut of comments. Either people say, man, I'm putting this on my playlist for when I run to get up that last hill, to people who are struggling with cancer or whatever, or have survived it and feel like, you know, that it's their anthem. So we're seeing that kind of across the board.
Well, you and your boyfriend, Garth, have both, you know, stuck your hearts out there and put your put things that mattered on the line, I think, both of you, with your music, and you should be proud of that. So congratulations, and you know I'm pulling for both of you all the time.
Wow,
love bragging on
you.
So congrats with everything.
We're having a good time. That's what it's all about.
Good deal. Thanks.
Thank you, Kix.